Today, Mechanical Pros, we're going to be looking at the Daikin X BRV heat recovery. I got Brian and Quentin. Both these guys truly are mechanical pros, certified Daikin BRV trainers. These guys train the guys that put all the stuff in. They know the equipment. We took the coil off. We're going to look at the guts. These guys are going to walk us through all the things of the VRV X heat recovery. All right, Brian, Quentin, I'm going to turn it over to you guys.
Hi guys, welcome to today's topic. We're going to talk about the VRV X, which John just mentioned. Quentin and I are both Daikin trainers. We train install and commissioning, so basically how to install it and start it up. But what we want to talk about today is all the new features that are in this product compared to the VRV 3 and then the VRV 4. So with that, I'm going to hand it off to Quentin and let him discuss more of the technical side on this.
Yeah, so we got a lot of cool new stuff going on with this module. So if you're familiar with the VRV 4 and VRV 3, you would always have to take off this entire panel to access your buttons. Now we have this nice little service window, pops right off of there, and you can get to your buttons without having to take the entire panel off. So we'll go ahead and expose what we have behind the panel there. So now you can see the inverter section. This is your inverter boards, noise filter board, diode bridge, and everything such as that. So you might be wondering what this copper line is running across the front of the unit. This is a cooling circuit for your inverters. Another thing that was really impressive with this new module is the new compressor. It's an inverter driven vapor injected scroll. So if you're familiar with the VRV 3, VRV 4, we used to have two smaller compressors. Now we just have one big guy in there. Suction accumulator, oil separator, liquid receiver back there in the back. You'll notice we have an array of electronic expansion valves. We have three four-way valves, one for your upper heat exchanger, one for your lower heat exchanger, and then one for switching over your dual pressure pipe. So with changing over that dual pressure pipe, we're able to accommodate various spaces. So we can operate in heating and cooling simultaneously in the same space. So all of the units attached to this heat recovery system do not have to operate in the same mode. Another thing that's pretty neat about this new machine is it has, on the condenser coil, which we have removed, it has that pan heater, which is integrated into the bottom of the coil. So we don't actually have to have any electronic components or anything like that to keep the pan from freezing up. So we're going into defrost mode. A concern a lot of times in colder climates is freezing around the bottom of that coil. Now we don't have that worry anymore because we're going to heat it in the heating mode.
Yeah, one thing I want to talk about for you VRF techs out there who have worked on Daikin and other products in the past, an Achilles heel I always thought as a service tech of the previous products were the pressure transducers on these. So if I had a bad low pressure transducer or a high pressure transducer, it was brazed into the refrigerant circuit, meaning I had to recover the entire charge. Well, I may have multiple indoor units attached to this device. That's a big deal, you know, having to tell the customer, hey, I got to shut everybody down. One great thing Daikin has done, and I love that they've done it, is they've now made flare fitting style pressure transducers. You can just screw them off and screw them back on with a Schrader under them on the high pressure and the low pressure as well. Knocks that repair down to literally 30 minutes to an hour. You don't have to recover gas. You don't have to pull vacuums. Change your part and move on to the next one.
Yeah, so that's a good point. Not much has changed as far as our control circuitry. All of our solenoids, thermistors, transducers, all of that stuff is integrated with the A1P printed circuit board. All of your control connections will still be made in the same location. All of your line voltage connections will also still be made in the same location. So not much has changed there. But overall, it's a totally redesigned, newly engineered piece of gear. Very impressive. In my opinion, it's the supercar of the VRF world. Really looking forward to getting my hands on some of these things. We've installed a few and had great success thus far. So
that's a great point Quentin made. If you're a tech in the field and you've worked on VRV 3 or 4, you're going to be able to walk up and not be blown away by this. You'll be able to get through the basic step modes to do the work you're used to doing on it. They have made changes and integrated better features in the system. But again, if you're familiar with the product, you'll be able to get up and run a call on this thing. Thank you guys for watching Mechanical Pros. Remember to hit that like and subscribe to watch what's coming next.